Singleton, and these beautiful Ozark Mountains of ours are just waiting for you. Of course, this is Jubilee USA. Ferlin Husky, Buck Owens, and Margie Singleton are visiting at our house. And right now, the star of our show, Red Foley!
Nothing else can do what love can do. I remember days gone by when I'd sit alone and cry, 'cause I had no one to kiss and to hold me tight. Love has turned the tide somehow, it's a different story now. Oh, I'm wrapped up in your arms this moonlit night. I tell you, love is love, can't call it nothing else. Does wonders by itself. Hallelujah, thank heaven up above. Darling, nothing else can take the place of love. You have made my dreams come true. I can smile because of you. You have given me your one and only heart. I'm so happy I could shout. I'm in love, there's no doubt. No, I can never, never part. I tell you, love is love, no matter where it's at. Love is love, that's all there is to that. Hallelujah, thank heaven up above. All is very, very great to say, call love.
If any of you folks happen to see that sign, you couldn't miss it. I think I saw it, and if I can pronounce it, it says Hinterwelder auf immer or something like that. Whatever that means back there. Hinterwelder. What's that mean, Bob? Oh, hillbillies forever. Bless you, boy. Well, that's German, I understand, but must be some German hillbillies with us this evening anyway. I guess the man would travel many miles to hear this lovely lady, Margie Singleton, sing a love song. Here she is, Margie Singleton. And please make her welcome. Won't you, Margie?
Again, somehow, have I told with all my heart and soul how I adore you? Well, darling, I'm telling you now. This heart would break in two if I should lose you. I'm no good without you anyhow. Have I told you lately that I love you? Well, darling, I'm telling you now. Have I told you lately, when I'm sleeping, every dream I dream is you somehow? Have I told you why the nights are long when you're not with me? Well, darling, I'm telling you now. I'm no good without you anyhow. Have I told you lately that I love you? Well, darling, I'm telling you now.
Singleton, a lovely lady with a lilting voice, singing, "Have I Told You Lately That I Love You?" Well, have I told you lately? Pay close attention to this next minute.
Broken Arrow, symbol of Apache peace, as the fearless warriors of the West ride through one of television's most exciting series. Broken Arrow, based on the life stories of two great men, the famous Apache chief Cochise and his white blood brother Tom Jeffords, sharing the drama and dangers of this turbulent period of bitter conflict when the whites swept over Apache lands in an irresistible wave. And only the cool heads and strong arms of these two men could keep this powder keg of violence from exploding into open warfare. Broken Arrow, starring John Lupton as Tom Jeffords, Michael Ansara as Cochise, filling the television screen with the adventure and action of the West's most exciting era, every week on ABC TV.
Don't forget the new time tomorrow, immediately preceding Maverick on most of these stations.
Well, sir, you know, in the springtime, a young man's fancy turns, so they say, to thoughts of love. And we sure have been leaning heavily on the love theme so far tonight. We're going to continue that theme with a young man who is more or less rocking up and up the ladder in our field by way of some of his big records. A nice welcome, if you will, please, to Buck Owens. Buck Owens.
Well, I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and love something that money can't buy. Well, a poor boy's chances for a pretty girl's glances are sometimes very few. Though I've got no money, if you'll be my honey, here's what I'll offer you. Well, I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. Yes, I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll love something that money can't buy. And I knew at a glance that I'd found my destiny. I would carry you off and marry you if you will agree. And I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. Yes, I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll love something that money can't buy.
What a nice to have you on our show. Well done, my boy.
Well,
sure.
Thank you, Red.
It's a habit that you seem to have, but tell me, I happen to know that was singing with you on the record, but for the benefit of the people, who was that fellow singing with you, I mean, on the record?
Oh, you mean my shadow? Why, that's Elmer.
You mean your shadow has a name?
Well, sometimes I call him Elmer, and sometimes I call him Shug Fisher.
Shug.
Here comes Elmer. Elmer. Here comes Elmer. The bear comes.
Oh, the Jones are on his
boots on and put his hunting breeches on and looked the fat shotgun on the wall. He made his mind up in there to bag himself a hunk of bear and his cotton he had plenty on the floor. Well, he milked the cow and fed the hog, then kissed his wife and called the dog, picked up his gun and started on his quest. He crossed the creek and hit the trees, threw back his head and sniffed the breeze, let out a yell and pounded on his chest.
Here comes Elmer, Elmer's got his gun. Here comes Elmer, run, bear, run.
He hunted all the morning through, but not a bear come into view, and Elmer's thoughts were on the kitchen range. For he was sick as he could be of lamb and chicken fricassee, and craved the best bear meat for a change. For Elmer's mind was in a fog, he paused and sat down on the log to get his faculties back in the groove. He heard a noise and standing there before him was a grizzly bear and figured it was time he made his move. He grabbed his gun and turned around, but Mr. Bear just stood his ground and Elmer said, it's either me or thou. The gun refused to go, and so he said somebody had to go and said, farewell, I'm leaving as of now. Then Elmer's shoulders sprouted wings, his feet developed into springs, and lingered longer, he was disinclined. He run so fast, muddy mire, his ankles set his socks on fire, but still the bear kept coming home behind.
Here comes Elmer, Elmer's got his gun. Here comes Elmer, run, bear, run.
Deer with antlers 8 foot wide got in the way of Elmer's stride, and both of them went heading for the brush. Then Elmer said, now listen, son, if that's the fastest you can run, move over, cause I'm really in a rush. The bear was gaining inch by inch and finally reached out for the cleats as Elmer saw the fence around his plate. Well, he leaped the fence and landed hard, jumped 60 feet across the yard and slammed the kitchen door and threw his face. Well, the bear was trying to get inside while Elmer saw the place to hide, and Mrs. Jones began to pull her hair. She said, this fuss has got to stop, why don't you let the matter drop? And Elmer said, go tell it to the bear. Then Elmer's wife said, listen, goon, how come you think you're Daniel Boone, whose appetite on bear meat used to thrive? He said, I'm sure that you're aware that Daniel always killed his bear, but I done brought this baby home alive.
Here comes Elmer, Elmer's got his gun. Here comes Elmer, run, bear, run!
There he is, Shug Fisher, and from Shug Fisher we turn to a song with a few sad overtones in it now. This is a song called The Last Train Ride. And by a boy that I'm sure you folks have enjoyed many times, Leroy Van Dyke.
Our city yards of the Phantom, they stood afraid and made up for the east. And the engineer with his oil and waste was grooming the great iron beast. While pin card back in the murky dust, a boxcar door swung wide. A hobo lifted his pile aboard, just caught on his last long ride. Lantern swung and the freight pulled out and the engine it gathered speed. The engineer pulled the throttle wide and he clucked to his fiery steed. While 10 cars back in the empty box, the hobo rolled a pill. The flare of the match showed his partner's face start white and deathly still. As the train wheels clicked on the coupling joints, a song for the rambler's ear. The hobo talked to the still white form, his pal for many a year. A mighty long time we've rambled, Jack, with the luck of men that roam, with the back door steps for a dining room and a boxcar for a home. We've dodged the bulls on the eastern route and the cops on the Chesapeake. We traveled the Leadville narrow gauge in the days of Cripple Creek. We even drifted down through sunny Cal on the rails of the old SP. And of all that you had, through good and bad, a half always belonged to me. You made me promise to you, Jack, if I live, you cashed in, to take you back to the old churchyard and to bury you there with your kin. Well, you seem to know that I keep my word, for you said that I was white. Well, I'm keeping my promise to you, pal, cause I'm taking you home tonight. I hadn't the money to send you there, so I'm taking you back on the fly. But it's a decent way for a beau to go home to the by and by. I knew that fever had you, Jack, but that doctor just wouldn't come. He was too busy treating the wealthy folks, the doctor a worn-out bum. As the train wheels clicked on the a couple of joints, song to the rambler's ear. The engineer in his high cap, he kept his eyes on the rails ahead. While 10 cars back in the empty box, the lonely hobo sighed. For the days of old and his pal to pull to was taking his last long ride.
Dyke. This is the time of year when you hear everybody on radio and television urging you to buy and use Easter seals. And I'd like to add our Jubilee voice to that plea. Easter seals fight crippling. Please do help this cause that's so very worthy. And right now, here's a message just for you.
Ride the swirling fury of a frozen wilderness in a dog sled powered by a team of Huskies. Gamble for gold in the toughest saloons along the Yukon Trail. Go prospecting with sourdoughs who stake their lives every time they stake a claim. Yes, there's adventure every minute of the way when you travel with The Alaskans, a TV series that captures all the color of the Klondike's rough and robust gold rush days.
I don't care.
Kinds of excitement, romance, humor, and plenty of lusty action with The Alaskans, starring Roger Moore, Dorothy Provine, Jeff York, every week on ABC TV.
Rugged Adventure tomorrow, following The Rebel on most of these stations.
You know, there's a young fellow in our business who is one of the finest mimics that I know of. He can just about mimic anybody that he hears. You can imitate just about anybody's voice, that is, anyway. But that's not why he's so well known, no siree. Actually, he is a singer among singers and a wonderful boy with it. Here he is, our very special guest for tonight, Ferlin Husky.
You bet it all over, more than anywhere else. Baby, when I'm out with you, well, I feel better all over, more than anywhere else. When you kiss me like you do, well, I'm as wild as a buck every time you call me up. Oh, you sure is a wonderful deal. I feel better all over, more than anywhere else. That's exactly how I feel. Well, I feel better all over, more than anywhere else, when you whisper in my ear. Well, I feel better all over, more than anywhere else. Anytime that you're near, well, my heart beats double time when I hold your hand in mine. Oh, you sure is a wonderful deal. I feel better all over, more than anywhere else. That's exactly how I feel. Well, I feel better all over, more than anywhere else, baby, when you hold me in your arms. I feel better all over, more than anywhere else, when you thrill me with your charms. I'm as fit as a fiddle. Oh, you make me want to kick up my heels. Oh, that is exactly how I feel.
Thank you very much. Red mentioned a while ago about me imitating other singers. Actually, I don't. They all imitate me. You see, when I get up in the morning, I sing real low, and Ernest Tubb started singing this way. So I try to clear my throat, so
I'm walking the floor over, sleep a wink, that is true.
Then I try to get my voice loosened up to sing higher to see how, you know, how I can get cleared up. And Webb Pierce started singing like this.
Slowly I'm falling. Oh,
strength.
And as I go along, I keep getting hoarser. And Kitty Wells heard me one morning, and she started copying me.
I can't stop loving. I've made up my mind to live in memory.
Of course, it kind of stops me up. And by then, I really get hoarse. Tex Ritter's made a million trying to imitate me on this.
Oh, the wayward wind. A restless wind that yearns to wander, and she was to the wayward wind.
Of course, I got to admit, I'm going to imitate a fellow now. It's L.D. Keller, as he calls a square dance for the Promenaders to start kicking on.
step with the times, and you're going to be in step with the times yourself after you've heard this.
I'm James Garner, also known as Brett Maverick. Usually I wind up in hot water on our show, but this week, a sweet-talking little blonde beats me to it.
Hey, who's in there?
None of your business.
Frankie?
Oh, hi, lover, that you?
That ruins Saturday night, and Sunday's even worse.
Well, I'm not even attracted to you. Well, you're very attractive. Well, you're just not the type that I... There's something about you.
It's kind of a mystery why nobody wants me around, so I start turning things upside down. But most of the trouble I find in Maverick Sunday night comes in a real nice package. Miss Connie Stevens as Frankie.
trouble awaits Brett tomorrow following Broken Arrow on most of these stations.
His arms are always open wide to those who want to step inside. No one has ever been denied the shelter of his arms. His arms may hold the earth and sky, but still they comfort those who cry, and those beyond the will to try found newborn strength in his arms. His embrace made me see the light I was hungry to see. Gone is the fear of the darkest night since I found his arms around me. I know his arms will open wide to those who wandered from his side. No one will ever be denied the love that's found in his arms.
And I know his arms will open wide to those who wander from his side.
No one will ever be denied love that's found in his arms.
Good night. You've been wonderful. Good night, Mama. Good night, Papa. You've been wonderful. Good night.
Next week, Little Miss Sweet Nothings herself, Brenda Lee, Alonzo and Oscar will join Red Foley on Jubilee USA. Jubilee USA is sent your way from the Jewel Theater in Springfield, Missouri, right in the heart of the Ozark Mountains. We're produced by Crossroads TV through the facilities of station KYTV. Joe Slattery saying, so long, everybody! The teacher learns a lesson and understands it. See Broken Arrow at its new later hour tomorrow, 7 Eastern, 6 Central Time on ABC.